Did you know there's a way to treat and improve dry eye symptoms using something called neurostimulation, where you stimulate the trigeminal nerve to increase baseline tears? Now, the most recent device designed to do this uses vibration to stimulate that nerve. Now, I don't have my hands on a device like this, but as I was researching and thinking about it at night when I was brushing my teeth, I wondered, is it possible to improve my dry eyes using my vibrating toothbrush? Let's focus in. Hey, howdy everybody, this is Dr. Neil Gaiman, Dr. Eye Guy, and I do videos all about the eyes to help you with your eyes. Now this video is going to be a little bit different because starting today, I'm going to do a 1 month long test to see if I can use the vibration from my toothbrush to stimulate my trigeminal nerve to help me with my dry eyes. Now let's first focus on what neurostimulation is, how it treats dry eyes, and what legitimate neurostimulation devices are out there. And at the end of the video, I'll give you my 1 month results to see if this actually worked. Okay, really quick, it's actually been a month and I have some interesting results to share with you at the end of the video. But right off the bat, I wanna say I'm not recommending to anybody to actually use their vibrating toothbrush for neurostimulation. And at the end of the video, I'll kind of go over my recommendations, but also my hesitation of why I won't continue to use my toothbrush, but also where I think neurostimulation treatment is headed. Neurostimulation is the activation of a neurosystem for therapeutic means. Now, scientists have discovered the trigeminal nerve plays a critical role in ocular surface health, symptomology, and overall homeostasis of your tears. Now let's focus in a little bit deeper. How the trigeminal nerve helps homeostasis of the tears is through the parasympathetic pathway, and it's all controlled by the lacrimal functional unit. The lacrimal functional unit can actually affect all aspects of the tears. It can affect the mucin or mucus layer of the tears, the water, the oil, the lacrimal gland, or even the oil glands in your eyelids. Now what we are interested in is if the trigeminal nerve actually improves our baseline tears in our eyes. There are three different types of tears: basal tears, reflexive tears, and emotional tears. The basal tears of our eyes are the baseline tears, the tears that are naturally in our eyes all day long. Reflexive tears are a response to an irritant, meaning you'll have a reflexive tear production. If you get a foreign body in your eye, onions, allergies, it will cause an increased production of tears that kind of flood the eyes. And then emotional tears are the happy, sad tears. Now the biggest worry with neurostimulation is that it's just causing reflexive tears, but they found in studies over time with repeated neurostimulation treatment, it did improve baseline tears, and that will improve your dry eyes and dry eye symptoms. These studies found that neurostimulation actually stimulated all aspects of the lacrimal functional unit, all areas of tears and tear production, and so neurostimulation over time increases your natural basal tears. Now the trigeminal nerve is a branch nerve that covers your face. There are branches around the eyes, nose, cheek. The most accessible portion of that nerve was right at the nose. And so we've been targeting that portion to try and stimulate the trigeminal nerve. The first available device for neurostimulation was something called TrueTear. This device actually had two long prongs that you'd actually, shove up right up your nose, and it would use electrical stimulation to stimulate the trigeminal nerve. Now studies this show by using this twice a day, 30 seconds per session, over time, it actually did improve your baseline tears and improve dry eye symptoms. As you can imagine, it didn't really catch on. It wasn't very comfortable to the patients. It was kind of weird to shove something up your nose. And so it kind of didn't become very popular. The new device that actually just got FDA approval for neurostimulation is called the EyeTear 100. Now this device is safer and definitely more comfortable to the patient. Instead of shoving something up the nose with an electrical stimulation, it actually has a vibrational stimulant on the outside of the nose. With this one, you actually use it for 30 seconds on each side of the nose twice a day, and studies did show over time with continued use, it did improve basal tears and improve dry eyes and dry eye symptoms. Now, I haven't been able to get my hands on this device yet, but once I do, I'll definitely do a full in-depth review of the EyeTear 100. Now, if this is using vibration, that's where I had the thought, I wonder if using the vibration for my toothbrush head could actually maybe improve my baseline tears as well. So here's the plan. Using the backside of a clean, fresh, vibrating toothbrush head, I'm gonna put it on the side of my nose 30 seconds each side twice a day for a month. I'm gonna follow the similar testing and guidelines they use for the eye tier 100. I'm gonna measure my baseline tears using the Schirmer test pre and post treatment. Before I use the toothbrush, after I use the toothbrush, first day, 14 day mark, month mark, probably a lot of days in between, and then I'll give you the results. Okay, here we go. This is my first time doing it. I have a brand new clean toothbrush tip here. I'm gonna do it 30 seconds on each side twice a day. I have a timer on my phone here. I'm expecting to sneeze like crazy. You're supposed to put it where the bony part of the nose ends and the cartilage starts. I'll probably have to move around to find the location of the nerve here. But yeah, here we go. Let's start the timer here. And okay. Oh yeah, here we go. Oh man. There it is. Okay. No, this is crazy. Got the tears going. Man, my toothbrush almost beeped. Woo! I got some tears flowing here. Oh man, why did I do this? Who's starting this? I'm gonna do this twice a day. Supposedly, at first, it's a little bit more jarring. You get a lot more response, sneezing, tearing. But supposedly, over time, it decreases a little bit. Yeah, we'll see if that actually happens. But whoa, okay, here we go. Let's do the other side. And start. There it is. Ooh. Yeah. Ah. Oh. Ugh. Here it is. Oh, man. Twice a day. I can do this. Ooh. There it is. Yeah, it has a 30 second timer on my toothbrush. That's going to be nice. I won't have to use my phone as much. It beeps when the 30 seconds happens. That's cool. Okay. Well, definitely have the tears flowing, nose is running, sneezing. I'm going to do it twice a day. It's my first time. It is in the morning. It's about 10 o'clock. So I'll do it tonight. And then in the morning before I go to work, and when I go get home and brush my teeth, I'll probably do it around the same time that I'm brushing my teeth here. So I'll switch tips. Don't worry. I'm not going to use the same tip for my toothbrush. I'm going to switch it. But yeah, here we go. Woo. Okay. That's fun. Okay, now for the much anticipated results. Now again, at the beginning of the month, I used the Schirmer test to measure my baseline tears or my basal tears, and I averaged about a 5, sometimes a 6, which is pretty low. At the end of the month, I measured a 12, sometimes a 14, which surprised me because that doubled, sometimes more than doubled my baseline tears. Now I did use the Schirmer test periodically through the month, and I'll put the results up on the screen here, but as you can see, it did show a slight increase throughout the month, which was pretty interesting. And I tried to keep other variables at a minimum. I tried not to alter any other dry eye treatments that I was already doing, but there are obviously going to be other variables in this isolated test that I was doing on myself. And I do have to say, I think my dry eye symptoms did also improve as well. At the beginning of the month, I did do a dry eye survey and compared it to the end of the month, and I did improve on that survey, so I thought that was interesting. Also, I noticed that my reflex of tears seemed to be improved or more potent, I should say. When I yawned, I'd definitely have more tearing. When I'd go outside and it was kind of bright, my eyes would water more, and they didn't seem to do that as much before, so I thought that was interesting as well. Okay, why will I not continue to use my toothbrush for neurostimulation? One of the biggest reasons is if I compare it to the iTier 100, the oscillating tip vibrates at a frequency of 220 to 270 hertz. A sonic toothbrush like this vibrates at a frequency of 12,000 to 24,000 hertz, way more. And a ultrasonic toothbrush vibrates even faster than that. Now, maybe that won't make a difference, but in my mind, I wonder if that faster vibration to the trigeminal nerve will cause other potential problems that I just don't know about. And there are some potential side effects of neurostimulation, even with the iTier 100. 1 to 2% of the people reported light sensitivity, dizziness. It could trigger a migraine. And so with the faster vibration, could those side effects even be greater, or could there be other side effects that I just don't know about? Now, one of the biggest downsides with the iTier 100 and definitely the toothbrush is sneezing. You will sneeze like crazy when using the iTier 100. And actually with the toothbrush, it's a little bit dangerous because when you'd sneeze, my head would flip down and you kind of risk poking your eye with the toothbrush. So I kind of had to move it out of the way. So yeah, I was putting myself at risk during this test. And that's another reason why I don't recommend actually using a toothbrush for neurostimulation. Now, the future is bright for neurostimulation. Here in the next few months, there's actually a nasal spray medication from Oster Point Pharma that will come out for neurostimulation. It's not a vibrational tool or anything. It's actually a nasal spray that can actually neurostimulate the trigeminal nerve. So that's going to be interesting. And when that comes out, I'm definitely going to see if I can get my hands on that, test it out, probably do another video on that as well. Now, for my recommendations, if you are interested in neurostimulation, definitely go see your eye doctor and talk to them about neurostimulation. Talk to them about getting the iTier 100 as an approved treatment for neurostimulation. I see this as being a treatment for all people with dry eyes. It could be an entry-level treatment. It can be used with eye drops in conjunction with your other dry eye treatment just to improve your baseline tears, your basal tears. And also in the next few months, definitely watch out for the release of the nasal spray medication for neurostimulation as well. If you found this video informational, definitely hit that like button and don't forget to subscribe. I have a lot more videos about dry eyes coming out here in the near future. Now, if you have any questions about neurostimulation or what it was like to actually use a toothbrush on my nose for a month, definitely leave it in the comments below. I try my best to answer all the questions that everybody leaves down there. I'm Dr. Neil Guyman, Dr. Eye Guy, focusing on you and your eyes. Make sure you check out my other videos right there, and I'll see you in the next video.